Hey guys, how's it going? In this video, we're going to be doing an unboxing and I'm going to give my first impressions on the Motorola Razr 2024. This phone is available at the time of this video. I'll have links to it in the description if you want to check it out for yourself. I purchased it directly from Motorola's website for $700 and it's also available on Amazon and Best Buy. It comes in three different colors. We have orange, sand, and this gray color we're going to be checking out here today. And there's one configuration of this phone. It comes packed with 8 gigabytes of RAM and 256 gigabytes of storage. But so we're not all staring at a box, let's go ahead and check out the 2024 Motorola Razr. Inside the box, we have some paperwork, a SIM ejection tool, and a USB Type-C to Type-C charging cable. Well, with all that out of the way, let's go ahead and check out the star of the show here, the 2024 Motorola Razr. First impressions, immediately out of the packaging, we have a really nice, smooth, eco leather on the back here. You can see that some of it does also transfer over to the front side of the phone. Go ahead and boot this up here, but the most noticeable change you're gonna notice right off the bat with this 2024 version is we have a much more usable outer display. This one's coming in at 3.6 inches. We had just a 1.5 inch screen on last year's. Taking a quick physical tour while this boots up, on the side we have our two volume rockers, we have our power button with the fingerprint sensor built in, in addition to one of our mics. On the left side, we have our SIM tray, which has room for just one SIM card, no micro SD slot here, but you can also use an eSIM with this phone. On the top, we have our stainless steel hinge. I also noticed that on this 2023 version on the right, the hinge is significantly larger, so we definitely have a trimmed down hinge over here on the 2024. And on the bottom, we have four more mics. We have one of our two speakers here, have the bottom speaker, and then the upper speaker here in the top. And then we also have our Type-C port capable of 30 watt wired charging. We also have some nice engraved Razr branding on the back here, and of course our Motorola logo. And this phone has aluminum sidings. And then taking a look on the inside, we have a 6.9 inch 1080p 120 hertz AMOLED display. As far as the crease in the middle, I'm really not feeling much here at all, and visually doesn't seem to be too bad either. But something that has really struck me initially here, just opening and closing this phone a few times, we have a very good opening and closing mechanism here on this phone. Obviously, it is a night and day difference compared to what Motorola was putting out a few years ago, but even compared to last year's 2023, this one just made more noise and was a little bit more difficult to open and close, just not as smooth and fluid of a flip phone experience as you might want. Whereas on this 2024 model, it just opens so smoothly. You don't feel any clicking of any mechanisms or anything in the opening and closing process, and it's really easy to just flip this open with your thumb. So it sounds a lot quieter when you're opening and closing it. And also there's a physical difference too. When you hear all those creaks on the 2023, you feel that too of the mechanism every time you open it, just whatever's going on in here, you can feel that every time you open and close it. Whereas on the 2024, the silent sound also translates to a very smooth feel. I know I just took this out of the box and just started using it, but I can already tell that this is the smoothest opening and closing of any flip phone I've used up to this point in time, even more so than my new Galaxy Z Flip 6. So I am definitely impressed with this 2024 Razr initially from a physical perspective, but I'm gonna go ahead, put my SIM card in here, set this phone up, use it for the day, and come back with my final first impressions of the 2024 Motorola Razr. All right, so it's been over a full day now since I first started using this 2024 Razr. I'm definitely ready to share some of my first impressions with you guys. So getting into the phone, the biometrics, we have the fingerprint sensor on the side. So super easy to get into this, whether you're on the inner or outer display. You will really quickly get the muscle memory to just open this phone up at a moment's notice and get in there really easily with the fingerprint sensor. We of course have face recognition as well, and you can also just use this to unlock to get into that outer display. And once you're in, you'll be greeted by the new 3.6 inch 1080p 90 hertz refresh rate AMOLED outer display. Definitely want to talk about this outer display first, since this is obviously the biggest change compared to last year's 2023 Razr. The 1.5 inch screen, you really just had a timepiece here in addition to a little weather forecast, a timer here, And then also I had an audio recorder set up here. There were a couple other widgets. You could see some notifications, but now similar to what we had on last year's 2023 Razer Plus, what's awesome to see this very large and usable and enjoyable outer display here on the cheaper Razer for this year. So on our main page here, we have the time, date, weather, battery percentage, and then you can choose four applications you want to have here really accessible. We also have a little icon down here. Anytime any notifications pop up, so you can just go ahead and tap that, check out your notifications, and everything except the apps also shows up on your always on display as well. So this can be toggled on and off. I turned it on even though it does take up some more of the battery life. We'll talk about battery next, but I really like this super large always on display on this phone. If you compare this to my Galaxy Flip, you can just see the difference in the always on displays here. Just have a little timepiece that's kind of hard to see, versus you can definitely see this from wherever you are. So really liking the always on display, can see your notifications there at a glance. Some really nice animations between the various things you do on the phone. Obviously, I can tap on any of these to open up an application. So have a Google Chrome browser here. And then as far as what you can do with the rest of this outer display, of course, we have our app panel here. Then we also have a little bit of weather here. So we can go ahead and switch between different locations if we want to really easily. We then have our usual timers and stopwatches. And then there's also these widgets that we can add. So depending on which apps you have downloaded on your phone, you're going to be able to have a bunch of different widgets here to put straight onto your outer display, which is nice. And it's nice that this is super accessible. I can click this edit button here, add any applications that I want to this outer display, just tap it and check it. And then it's really easy to just go ahead, grab, hold, and move some of your applications if you need to. So let's just go ahead and open up YouTube here. Now it's nice that whatever application you're in, you can press down on this bottom bar to change the size of it. So if there was a button that you couldn't hit before because of the cameras being in the way, if you see here, if I hold this again, you can see that some of my buttons down here are missing. I could probably tap in the corner of it. No, see, I can't reach it. So if I hold this down, then it's super easy to just come over here and go ahead and tap something that you want to have access to. And then you can just go ahead, hold it down again, and then you can go back to that full screen. So it's nice that you can swap between these two for whatever you may need. Now, since we do have the cameras here, they would get in the way of the keyboard. So this is as large as you can make the keyboard, but I will do a little typing test here. Thanks so much for watching. So it is doable, but a larger keyboard than on the inside and a lot easier to type on that display. Now, since we're typing here, I want to mention the haptics on this phone, because I think the haptics have been greatly improved on this 2024 Razer compared to the 2023 version. You still have a really nice feel on this 2024 version, but it doesn't have the sound effect that went along with the 2023 one. For some reason, that little sound would always get under my skin. Here's the sound bit. And then on the inside, we have our 6.9 inch 1080p 120 hertz refresh rate AMOLED display. This has been a great screen size for me in my first day of use with how compact of a phone this is when it's folded up. Although it is worth keeping in mind that this is a more narrow phone compared to some of your conventional smartphones. So if I compare this side by side with my iPhone 15 Pro Max, you can see how much more wide of a display we have on just more conventional smartphones out there. So it is definitely something to keep in mind. However, it does make the feel in the hand very good on this. We are getting a great screen size for something that doesn't feel all too bulky in your hand. I think what helps too with that is that overall we have more rounded sidings on this Razer compared to something like my Galaxy Flip that is a lot more squared off on the sidings and edges. You definitely have a very comfortable feel here, and the opening and closing, I know I already talked about it at the start of this video, but I cannot understate how good the opening and closing experience is on this phone. It is just super smooth from start to finish. And what I also notice is that closing is much easier at the top end of the phone. What I mean by this, on the 2023 version, for some reason, the mechanism was really, really strong and tight at the top. So you have to press really hard on the top. And then when you do that, it just kind of makes the phone kind of really fly shut. And I'll show a segment here. I almost dropped this phone a few times when out and about because I was pressing this top end really hard to close it. And then you kind of lose grip of the phone, or make sure you catch it when you're kind of pushing it down towards yourself. Whereas on this 2024 version, it's just super smooth. You don't have that kind of really whiplash sort of reaction when you press down on it. It's just really smooth the whole way through, and very easy to open and close. As far as the crease on this phone, you can see it when you put this phone in direct sunlight. However, when the phone is facing directly towards you, even when the screen is off, you don't even really notice it. And what's more important is that when you run your finger over it, you barely feel it at all. When you're just using this phone on the inner display for your everyday tasks, you really don't even notice or feel that crease at all. Now, as far as the battery life goes, this comes packed with a 4200 milliamp hour capacity battery. So we used about half of the battery in a day's time. Yesterday, I had about 3 hours of screen on time between watching some YouTube, doing some text messaging, some emails, replying to your comments, browsing the web, doing some productivity in Excel. And then today so far, 1 hour and 16 minutes. So overall, 4 hours of screen time using up half of the battery. That means we're on pace here for 8 hours of screen on time battery life. And this is from using both the outer and inner displays. So I'm also very impressed initially with the battery life. Taking a look at the cameras, we have our 50 megapixel primary lens. We have a 13 megapixel ultra wide lens. There is a 2x zoom option in the camera's viewfinder, but this is just a digital zoom and this goes up to 10x digital zoom. Initial pictures look good in my testing. However, video once again on this year's Razer is looking a little less than optimal for my preferences personally. So we have the 1080p 60 here and then switching over to the 4K 30. Either one you use, it does look kind of choppy and there doesn't appear to be any optical image stabilization here. So action shots are gonna probably look a little choppy. And even just doing some standstill shots here and just panning the camera left and right, you can see here that there's just some choppiness from time to time. Even though I'm filming here at 1080p 60, this should be a pretty smooth video at 60 frames per second. There's just some chopping going on. So on the video side of things, definitely some room for improvement here, but I guess the picture itself looks fine and gets the job done in a pinch. Probably the coolest and most useful feature of this camera is having a viewfinder on the outer display. So I'm taking a picture of somebody, you can see here that they're gonna be able to see themselves and see how the picture is going to turn out. So very cool to have this now on this 2024 Razer. You can just go ahead, press the button there, and you can see it's going to take a picture and it'll show the person what the picture came out as. We also now have official water resistance on this Razer, an IPX8 water resistance rating. So going from simply splash proof to now being able to submerge this phone in water for a sustained period of time is pretty nice quality of life to have. We also now have upgraded wireless charging on this. So we had it for the first time on last year's Razers, but it was only 5 watts, so it takes a very long time. As far as the processor in this, this is packed with the MediaTek Dimensity 7300X processor. In my first day of use, everything on this phone has been super smooth and responsive. I haven't done any gaming on this yet, but as far as just your average everyday applications like YouTube, opens up perfectly fine. Going into Google Chrome, opens up perfectly fine here. See a nice smooth 120 hertz refresh rate. Very easy to multitask on this, just swipe up from the bottom, tap at the top, split top, and then you can go ahead and select something else. And then you have a good split screen experience here. You can see you can resize this and not much waiting or loading time at all. So pretty happy with the performance so far. And even though we don't have the best aspect ratio here for gaming and watching videos and things, it still has a comfortable feel in the hand and definitely gets the job done. And we have a nice dual speaker setup to go along with it.
2023, which at the time of making this video is the most affordable, foldable, flippable smartphone at just $500.
But overall, first impressions of the 2024 Razer, I am super impressed with this phone initially, especially for the price. Have a really good outer display experience here. A lot of versatility with this phone between the inner and the outer displays. And overall, pound for pound, I'd say this is a very competitive phone with the new Z Flip 6. Even though we don't have nearly as good video on this Razer's video camera, we are getting a larger outer display in addition to a larger inner display. But that's it for now. I'm definitely going to be doing a 1 month review on this, so stay tuned to the channel for that. I'll be curious to hear your thoughts on this 2024 Razer down in the comments below. Make sure to leave a like on your way out, and thanks so much for watching. Take care.